Good morning, students. Today I am going to explain the problems which are related to polynomial functions which are reducible to quadratic equations. Mainly I will focus on those problems only here. The problems are related to polynomial functions which are reducible to quadratic equations and other polynomial solutions of other polynomial equations. Now, before going to give the solutions of the polynomial equations of different degree, I will give certain points which are useful in dealing the solutions of these equations. The first important point is, if fx equal to 0 be a polynomial equation, of real coefficients, the coefficients are real here, of real coefficients, then the irrational or complex roots of fx equal to 0 are always pairwise conjugate. That is one important point related to polynomial equations, particularly polynomial equations of real coefficients. So once fx equal to 0 be the given polynomial equation of real coefficients, then the irrational roots or complex roots of given polynomial equation are pairwise conjugate. Pairwise conjugate in the sense, before going to explain this meaning, pairwise conjugate meaning, one must know about irrational roots or complex roots. Suppose the root is of the form a plus root b or a minus root b or root a plus root b or minus root a plus root b or minus root a minus root b, etc. The root that consists of irrationality, square roots. So the roots which are of the form either a plus or minus root b or root a plus or minus root b or minus root a plus or minus root b, like that, such roots are known as irrational roots. Once you replace x with the given irrational root and the equation is satisfied, then it becomes a root. So once the root is an in the irrational form, suppose the a plus root b is a root of the given equation, its conjugate, is a minus root b, is its conjugate. This is also a root. Similarly, if a minus root b is the root of the given equation, then its conjugate a plus root b is also a root. That means a plus or minus root b are one is the conjugate of the other. Similarly, for root a plus root b, the conjugate serves are minus root a plus root b or root a minus root b or minus root a plus root a minus root b minus root a plus root b is the conjugate of either this or this, is the conjugate of that irrational root. So once the root is in irrational form, its conjugate is also a root to the given polynomial equation. These two are said to be, these two are, or these two are, or these two are said to be pairwise conjugate roots. Once irrational root exists to the polynomial equation, then that must be pairwise conjugate. Its conjugate is also a root. That is the concept here. This is in case of irrational roots. Similarly, in case of complex roots. Complex roots means if the root is of the form alpha plus I beta, if the root is of the form alpha plus I beta, where alpha beta are real numbers, I stand for iota, which is a complex number completely. If this complex number is a root of the given equation, then its conjugate, the conjugate of this complex number is alpha minus I beta. This is also a root to the given equation. If alpha minus I beta is a root of the given equation, then its conjugate alpha plus I beta is also a root. For example, 2 plus 3i is a root. That implies 2 minus 3i is also a root of the given equation. Once the equation has real coefficients only, that is more important here, worth note point here. Once the given polynomial equation has real coefficients, then irrational roots or complex roots or pairwise conjugate. That is very important point related to the polynomial equations, solving the polynomial equations. Now, based on that, on this point particularly, I will give one problem to you. Let us consider a problem based on this point. Solve x power 4 plus 2x cube minus 16x square plus 22x plus 7 equal to 0, whose one root is 2 plus root 3. That is the problem here. You have to find the other roots of the given biquadratic equation, because the maximum power of the variable here is 4. Hence, this is biquadratic equation, polynomial equation with real coefficients 1, 2, 16, minus 16, minus 22. These are all real numbers. So, the given biquadratic equation with real coefficients has one root as 2 plus root 3, which is irrational. In such case, you have to find the other roots. Every biquadratic equation has at most 4 roots. Out of 4 roots, one root is given as 2 plus root 3. So, here we have to find the other 3 roots. That is the task here. So, to find the other roots of the given polynomial equation, we can use this point here to solve this equation. Let f x equal to here x power 4 plus 2x cube minus 16x square minus 22x plus 7. The polynomial function, that's f x, is considered as a polynomial function, given polynomial function. Given here, 2 plus root 3 is a root. Root of f x equal to 0. That means the given equation. Given 2 plus root 3 is a root of f x equal to 0. That implies and implied, of course, 2 minus root 3, because this is the conjugate of this root. 2 minus root 3, is also a root, is also a root of f x equal to 0 itself, because 2 plus root 3 is a root since it is irrational, and the given equation, polynomial equation, is an equation of fourth degree having real coefficients. Clearly its conjugate, the given root's conjugate, is 2 plus root 3 conjugate is 2 minus root 3, is also a root. So out of four roots, already we get two roots. Based on these two roots, based on these two roots, we will get a factor of fx, a second degree factor of fx. Since 2 plus root 3, otherwise, since alpha equal to 2 plus root 3, let beta equal to 2 minus root 3 be the roots of f x equal to 0, then x square minus of alpha plus beta x plus alpha beta, which is equal to x square minus alpha plus beta, sum of these two roots is 4. So minus 4x plus product of these two roots, alpha into beta, 2 plus root 3 into 2 minus root 3, that gives us 4 minus 3. 4 minus 3 is 1, is a factor. It becomes a factor to fx. Since both the roots 2 plus root 3 and 2 minus root 3 are the roots, the factor correspond, factor of fx, the factor of fx corresponding to these roots, corresponding to these roots, is obtained by x square minus of sum of the roots multiplied by x plus product of the roots. So this is a second degree factor to this polynomial function. Now divide, divide fx with x square minus 4x plus 1. The division may be considered by Horner's method, that means synthetic division method, or straight away division, whichever method you may apply. Here I will go through the Horner's method or synthetic division method. To divide the given fx, the polynomial function, in LHS of the equation, in LHS of the equation, with a quadratic function which is of the form x square plus ax plus b. This is of the form x square plus ax plus b. Let us assume that the second degree factor is x square plus ax plus b. Now I will divide the given fx with this quadratic factor. The division is in such a way, here I am using Horner's method or synthetic division method. In synthetic division method, let us consider the coefficients, in the row, first row, 1, 2, minus 16, minus 22, 7. Let us write the coefficients of the given function in first row, in row wise. If any term is absent, suppose x cube term is absent in the equation, you have to take 0 as its coefficient. Once, suppose x square coefficient is absent in the equation, correspondingly x square coefficient is considered as 0. So take the coefficients here and take here the division with minus a. Here a is minus 4, minus a is minus a, minus a equal to 4, and take minus b, minus b equal to minus 1. Taking the division with this quadratic by Horner's method, take, assuming this quadratic as x square plus ax plus b, here a is minus 4. Take here minus a. Similarly, comparing this one, b equal to 1. Take here minus b. Now the division starts like this. Let us consider 0, 0 here. Let us consider 0, 0 here. Adding these three, 1 plus 0 plus 0, we get 1. Now multiply this one with 4. 1 into 4, that gives us 4. And let us take 0 here. Adding these three, we get 6. Now multiply 6 into 4, 24. 6 into 4, 24. And 1 into minus 1, you write here minus 1. Multiply this one with 4. 6 into 4, right here. And 1 into minus 1, you write minus 1 here. Adding this, you get 24 minus 17, 7. Now similarly, 7 into 4, 28 here. 6 into minus 1, write minus 6 here. 7 into 4, 28, right here, 28. And 6 into minus 1, you write minus 6 here. So adding this, you get clearly 0. Repeat the same process. 0 into 4, write 0 here. 7 into minus 1, minus 7 here. So again you get 0. Once you divide this fourth degree function with a second degree function, the remaining divide fx with x square minus 4x plus 1. Here I am using synthetic division, that means Horner's method to divide, or you can straight away divide the fourth degree equation with this fourth degree function with this second degree function. The remaining second degree factor, the remaining other factor is, second degree factor is, this is x square coefficient, 1 into x square. This is x square coefficient. This is x coefficient, plus 6 into x. This is constant term, plus 7. The other factor of the division, once you divide, that means once you divide fx with x square minus 4x plus 1, you get the other factor as here x square plus 6x plus 7. That is the procedure. Straight away you can divide the polynomial with this second degree factor. Otherwise, you can use this Horner's method to find the other factor, second degree factor. It gives us x square coefficient. It gives us x term. It gives us constant term. So hence you can write, therefore you can write the given equation, therefore x power 4 plus 2x cube minus 16x square minus 22x plus 7 equal to 0 implies, it can be written as the product of two factors, x square minus 4x plus 1, and the other factor is x square plus 6x plus 7 equal to 0. Once you divide the second degree factor obtained by these irrational roots, the other factor is x square plus 6x plus 7 equal to 0. That means here the biquadratic equation is resolved as the product of two second degree factors. Already the roots of these second degree factors are known to us, 2 plus root 3 and 2 minus root 3. The other two roots are given by this factor. So x square minus 4x plus 1 equal to 0 implies x takes 2 plus root 3 comma 2 minus root 3. These are the roots already given to us. and the other factor, once you equate that other factor to zero, you get the other roots. So that is, the roots are given by x equal to minus b plus or minus square root of b square 6 square minus 4ac by 2a, 2 into 1. Just I am using the straight away formula, minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. Based on this, we get minus 6 plus or minus square root of 36 minus 28 by 2, which gives us minus 6 plus or minus root 8. Here root 8 may be written as 2 root 2 by 2. Dividing with 2, we get minus 3 plus or minus root 2. So the other two roots are here, the other two roots are minus 3 plus root 2, minus 3 minus root 2. The total roots, therefore, roots of fx equal to 0 are 2 plus root 3, that is one root, the given root, and its conjugate is also a root, and minus 3 plus root 2, this is one root, its conjugate minus 3 minus root 2. Or the roots, four roots of the given biquadratic equation. This is the way of solving a biquadratic equation, provided that one root is known and the given root is also an irrational root or complex roots also, we can use this process. Okay. I will give one more problem based on this. Another problem. Solve the equation. Another biquadratic, I am taking another biquadratic. X power 4 plus x cube minus 20x square plus 16x plus 24 equal to 0, whose one root is, minus 3 plus root 5, whose one root is minus 3 plus root 5. This is similar to that of previous problem. Here the root is clearly an irrational roots. Just I am emphasizing the irrational roots because so far you are not familiar with the complex numbers. That's why I am emphasizing on irrational roots. So here to solve the given equation, the given root is minus 3 plus root 5, which is an irrational root. So based on that irrational root, we get one quadratic, which is a factor to that function. And dividing that function or biquadratic with this quadratic, we get another factor. Based on the factors, we get the required solutions or roots of the given equation. That is the procedure here. That means you have to resolve the given function as a product of two factors of second degree. That is the main theme here. So given root is here, let fx equal to x power 4 plus x cube minus 20x square plus 16x plus 24. Let us consider the LHS part of the equation as fx, because RHS is clearly 0. Given minus 3 plus root 5 is a root. Root of f x equal to 0. Root means the value of x which satisfies that equation. Once you put x equal to minus 3 plus root 5, clearly it gives us 0. So, minus 3 plus root 5 is an irrational root to the given equation. Hence, that implies and implied minus 3 minus root 5 is also a root, the conjugate of the given root. As per our given point, I am taking the conjugate of this root. The conjugate of this root is minus 3 minus root 5. Let these roots be alpha and beta. So, here alpha plus beta, sum of the roots is minus 6. Product of the roots, minus 3 plus root 5 into minus 3 minus root 5, which is minus 3 whole square minus root 5 whole square. A plus b into a minus b, a square minus b square. A square minus b square is 9 minus 5, that is 4. Alpha plus beta is here minus 6 and alpha beta is 4. Now, the second degree, I will construct the second degree factor to fx. So, the second degree factor of fx, the second degree factor of fx is corresponding to this alpha and beta, is x square minus of alpha plus beta x plus alpha beta, which is x square. Alpha plus beta is minus 6, minus of minus, minus of otherwise minus 6 into x plus alpha beta is 4 plus 4, which is x square plus 6x plus 4. This is the second degree, one second degree factor of fx, one second degree factor of fx corresponding to these roots. Now, divide fx with this second degree factor. Now, dividing. Dividing fx with x square plus 6x plus 4. We get the division is considered through synthetic division method or Horner's method. Horner's method, I will use Horner's method for the division. So, let us consider the coefficients here. 1 again, minus 20, 16, 24. Take the coefficients along with the signs. Along with the signs, you have to consider the coefficients in the first row. Now, you have to divide with this second degree factor. Assume that second degree factor as x square plus ax plus b. Comparing this second degree factor with this one, here a equal to 6, b equal to 4. So, take minus a, that is minus 6, minus b, that is minus 4. You have to divide the coefficients with this one. Let us start the division with 0, 0 here. Adding this column elements, 1 plus 0 plus 0, 1. Multiply this one with minus 6, right here, minus 6. 1 into minus 6, take 0 here. This is the procedure of synthetic division method or Horner's method. So, adding this, we get minus 5. Now, multiply minus 5 and minus 6, you write that product here. 30. Minus 6 into minus 5 gives us 30, plus 30. And multiply this one with this minus 4 and write here 1 into minus 4, minus 4. Adding, we get 6. 30 minus 24, that gives us plus 6. Continue that process. 6 into minus 6, right here, minus 36. Minus 5 into minus 4, plus 20 here. Adding clearly, it gives us 0. 0 into minus 6, we get 0 here. 6 into minus 4, minus 24 here. Adding, we get 0. So, this is the synthetic division method or Horner's method of dividing a polynomial function with a quadratic. Now, clearly this is x square coefficient, this is x coefficient, this is constant term in other factor. So, therefore, the other quadratic factor, other quadratic factor of fx is, this is x square coefficient, hence 1 into x square is x square, minus 5 into x plus 6. This is one other quadratic factor of fx. Already one quadratic factor is obtained through given roots. The other factor, quadratic factor, is obtained by this division. If it is not possible to do so, you can straight away divide fx with the second degree factor and get the other second degree factor. So, therefore, the equation, given equation, x power 4 plus x cube minus 20x square plus 16x plus 24 equal to 0 implies, this can be written as the product of x square plus 6x plus 4, one factor. The second degree other factor is 6. You can write the given equation as the product of two factors, second degree factors. Hence, therefore, x square plus 6x plus 4 equal to 0. Once you equate this factor to 0, then x is clearly minus 3 plus root 5, comma minus 3 minus root 5, already given roots. Because that factor is, that second degree factor is obtained by these roots. And once the other factor x square minus 5x plus 6, making it to 0, you can factorize this as a linear factors, namely x minus 2 into x minus 3 equal to 0. Hence, x equal to 2 comma 3. So, the total roots, roots of the given equation, hence, the total roots of the equation fx equal to 0 is, therefore, roots of given equation fx equal to 0 or minus 3 plus root 5 is one root, minus 3 minus root 5, its conjugate is another root, and 2 comma 3 or other roots. So, since it is a fourth degree or biquadratic equation, we have 4 roots at maximum. So, the 4 roots are here, minus 3 plus root 5, minus 3 minus root 5, 2 and 3. These two are integral roots. Integral roots means integer roots. These two are irrational roots. So, the equation has two integer roots, integral roots, and two irrational roots. That is the procedure in solving such problems. The same analogy you can extend in case of in case the given function or the given equation has a complex root. Suppose instead of irrational root, suppose 2 plus 3i is a root, let us consider the other root as 2 minus 3i. You add these two and taking the product I square, taking I square as minus 1, you get the same second degree equation and go through the Horner's method to divide that function, LHS function involved in the given equation, LHS part of the given equation, with that quadratic by applying this Horner's method or synthetic division method, get the other second degree factor and find the value of x from the other second degree factor, which gives us the solutions of the given equations. The same concept you can extend in case of complex roots. Here, the biquadratic is reduced as factors of quadratic. That is main point.